It all starts with an idea that you're free, you live life the way you want to, and that the entire point of your existence is to have fun. You start school as an innocent kid, and by the end of primary, you know all about the male and female private parts. You're already confused about the 58 genders that apparently exist, even though your science teacher says that there must be two genders for us to evolve from monkeys. By the end of high school, you're taught all the ins and outs of contraception, sex and whatnot. I remember when I was 15, showing how to put a condom on a banana, even though in the UK, the law says that sex is at 16. Every time you go out, every billboard, every movie, game, social media post, and even every person that you see is constantly triggering one thing, your sexual instinct. And it doesn't stop there. You become infected with one of the worst diseases in society, porn. All your friends watch it. Seeing all this filth online start to change the way you think. Males specifically start to view women as an object which satisfies their desires. This opens up another filthy disease, masturbation. You start to get off on these fantasies online, each session requiring something even more extreme to make you happy. But after doing that for a bit, it's no fun anymore. You have to try something more exciting. Aha, why not DM the girl who goes to my school? She's fit. I want her to send me a naked picture. A female is viewed just as a piece of meat to satisfy your desires. But it goes further. Porn isn't enough anymore. Your hand isn't enough anymore. Pictures are not enough anymore. You want the real thing. So you get into a haram relationship and start to have sex outside of marriage. Sex makes babies, which you don't want. So what do? You kill them. Your whole relationship is about how your partner looks, and it becomes very superficial. And it starts to break down. You end up with broken families, broken relationships, and broken morals. And this system leads to a broken society, a society of hypersexualized criminals. Harmful sexual behavior starts to increase in school and in college. But it doesn't end there. It even spreads to public places and workplaces. All this crime, sexual frustration, the idea of being free, it leads to the ultimate sexual violation, rape. 1.7 million adult women have been raped in the UK. Unfortunately, it still doesn't end there. The ferociousness of the sexual pandemic ends up targeting the most vulnerable portion of society, children. 3.1 million people in the UK said that they experienced sexual abuse as a child. That's 3.1 million children, kids, and even babies. This disease of sexual freedom spares nobody. Even animals have become victims of rape by other human beings, or so-called human beings. Sexual assault, rape, broken relationships, and a hypersexualized society are a direct result of the system we live in. So why not fix it? If porn is such a massive problem affecting the youth, why not ban it? Because sites like Pornhub have 3.5 billion viewers every month, making it the 10th most visited site in the world. Nudity in advertisements, movies, social media, it attracts customers. And businesses, they take advantage of this. Nakedness on the streets and the relationships people are involved in are granted by the freedom to dress however they want and love whoever they want. This is a direct result of the system. From a crime and punishment perspective, rapists, for example, are barely ever convicted, and most of them get away perfectly free. However, under an Islamic system, this problem would be dealt with from the very root. Imagine waking up, flicking through your phone, maybe on a male-only or female-only social media platform, where you don't even see any pictures of the opposite gender. Porn isn't even an option, because it is absolutely banned. Walking out of your house and all the people are dressed according to Islamic law. Women specifically cover up and hide their beauty except in the privacy of their own homes. You go to school where the genders are segregated. Males study with males and females study with females. And part of your education is about taqwa, you know, being conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the value of marriage and how Islam views the roles of men and of women. The only intimate relationship allowed under this Islamic system is marriage, and any other relationship is unlawful, where sex outside of marriage, if proven, would be punished severely and publicly to act as a deterrent for the rest of society. The Islamic system would exterminate hypersexualization, abortions, broken families, divorce rates, sexual harassment, porn addiction, rape, pedophilia, and all other evils which are promoted in the system that we live in. Overall, this is a brief summary of how society would run within the Islamic system. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created every human being with a sexual instinct, and He has given us Islam to guide us in how to regulate this instinct. Otherwise, without guidance, society becomes enslaved to its own desires instead of being enslaved to its own creator.